Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to give my special thanks to Professor So for inviting me. The title of my talk is Transverse Killing Forms on a Polated Riemannian Manifold. Let me give my talk by giving the basic fact about pollation. Let MGMF be a Riemannian manifold with a pollation F of codimension Q and a bundle-like metric GM. A pollation is a class of same dimensional submanifold. A bundle-like metric is a metric for which the leaves of the pollation remain locally at constant distance from each other. Let TF be the tangent bundle of the pollation. Q is the normal bundle of pollation. A vector field Y is infinitesimal automorphism if the bracket of Y and G is tangential to pollation for every tangential vector G. This means a flow generated by an infinitesimal automorphism preserves the leaves. Now let omega B be the space of all basic forms on a manifold which satisfies IXP and DIXP is equal to 0 for any tangent vector x to the pollation. And any form on manifold is decomposed as basic forms and others. So we can consider the mean curvature form of submanifold leaves, then KB be the basic part of K. Delta B be the formal adjoint operator of DB. DB is the restriction of exterior differential to a basic space. The operators AY, basic Laplacian, defined by equation 1 and equation 2. Here, sister Y is a transverse derivative. And Nabla is the transverse left shift connection. Actually, the transverse left shift connection on pollated manifold is given by this form. here, pi is the projection from TM to a normal bundle. Pi pop is the projection from TM to L. Then we denote R or rigid sigma be curvature tensor, transversal rigid tensor, transversal scalar curvature of pollation. Then we can define the curvature endomorphism like this equation. Okay. Here, EA is the local orthonormal basic frame on the normal bundle. And the theta A, it's a dual form. Especially if P is a basic one form, then FP is just a transversal rigid curvature. So we have the generalized Bayesian-Buck formula is given by this formula, where this operator is this form. Actually, this is a self-adjoint operator. Then we have the generalized maximum principle. Let F be a Riemannian pollation on a closed connected Riemannian manifold if delta V minus KV is positive or non-negative or non-positive for any basic function f, then f is constant. Now we give the definitions about conformal forms, Killing forms. A basic R form is called transverse conformal form if for any vector field x, p satisfies this equation. Here delta t is equal to delta b minus ikb. Ik means interior product. Additionally, any transversal conformal form satisfying delta tp is equal to zero is called transverse Killing form. So actually, why is infinitesimal automorphism then? Why is transversal conformal Killing field satisfy this equation? Transversal Killing field satisfy this equation. So, transverse conformal one form or Killing one form is actually a dual form of a transversal conformal or Killing vector field. Also, on the transverse spin foliation, transverse conformal forms, respectively Killing forms, are related to transversal twist spinors, respectively Killing spinors, which is a solution of equation, this equation. Here, dB is the basic Dirac operator. A basic form is a transverse Killing form if and only if P satisfies this equation for any normal vector field. Also, basic form P is a transverse Killing form if and only if P satisfies this Bayesian-Box type formula. So we have this lemma. On the Riemannian foliation, any basic R form P satisfies this inequality. The equality holds if and only if P is a transverse conformal form. And if P is a transverse conformal form, then P var, this one, ER plus 1 U P is also transverse conformal R form with respect to the conformal metric. Now, we define the operator TTR. TTR means R forms to this form. This form is intersection of the kernels of wedge product and contraction map. Then we define this equation. So P is transverse conformal form if and only if the kernel of this operator. Now we review the star bar operator from R forms to Q minus R form given by this form. So this form preserve this form this star operator preserve the basic forms. Here, chi f is the characteristic form of the foliation. Star is the Hodge star operator. Then we can define the global inner product like this equation. Then we generalized Bayesian-Box formula. On Riemannian foliation, we have the following. equations, t star, t, this means dual operator of t, is this equation. Here dt is dv minus kv wedge. dt is a formal adjoint of delta t. Then on the space of basic forms, t star t and star bar operator commute. From these properties, any basic R form P is a transverse conformal R form if and only if star P is a transverse conformal Q minus R form. Then we have some integral formulas. Any transverse conformal R form P is transverse conformal R form, then P satisfies this equation. And also we have this equation. From this equation we have by using the Schwarz inequality, then we have this inequality. So from this inequalities we have this theorem. Let MGMF be a compact Riemannian manifold with a foliation F and Bundelecker metric GM such that KB is co-closed. Generally, the basic forms is automatically closed. So we add, we need this equation, KB KB is co-closed. Suppose curvature endomorphism is non-positive and negative at some point, then for any R, there are no transverse conformal R form. For the proof, from this equation, from these inequalities, this term is non-negative. So 2R minus Q is non-negative. Then right-hand side is non-negative. But the assumption is non-positive. So we have there are no transverse conformal R form on this about this R. And now in this case, star bar is star operator is isometry, and the star bar P is also transverse conformal form. So we have P is transverse conformal form, so others are transverse conformal forms. So we have this all of R, there are no transverse conformal forms. And as corollaries, we have F is cosy negative means non-negative. Non-positive, and at some point positive. So there are no transverse killing R forms. Okay. Now we studied the transverse killing forms on Kerr foliation. Kerr foliation satisfies the following three conditions. First, F is Riemannian. Second, there is an almost complete structure J such that this equation. And third, J is parallel. If we define basic, if we define two form like this one, then omega is basic two form, and also omega is closed as a consequence of these two properties. And also the basic two form can be expressed by this formula. As examples, cataphylation, examples of cataphylation are first Sasakian manifold. Sasakian manifold is a cataphylation with one-dimensional foliation generated by the structure vector. Second, the generalized Hopf vibration. Third, the fibered space, warped space. And so on. We have many cataphylation. And also, we have these properties. R and J commute. And R, Jx, Jy is Rxy for any normal vector P. Also, on a cataphylation, IEA, IEB, R, EA, JEB is equal to 0. And also, we have another equation. For any basic R form, P, F and I omega commute. And the bracket delta B and I omega is this one. And AX I omega is this one. Here I omega means minus 1 over 2 IJEA IEA. Okay. If KB is transversally holomorphic. Holomorphic means theta KJ is equal to 0. Then the bracket delta B I omega and AK I omega satisfy this one, this equation. From previous equations, we have on a cataphylation, if P is transverse Killing R form, then I omega P is a transverse Killing R minus 2 form. For the proof, note that a basic form P is transverse Killing form, then P satisfies this equation. And also omega is parallel, so this equation is trivial. This means I omega P is also transverse Killing form. Now, MGM, FJ, we compact Riemann and manifold with cataphylation of co-dimension Q and the bundle-like metric GM. Assume that KB is transversally holomorphic. If P is transverse Killing R form, then I omega P is a parallel transverse Killing R minus 2 form. So, we prove let P be a transverse Killing form, then I omega P is also transverse Killing form. Then from the Weizenbach formula, I omega P satisfies this equation. And since KB is transversal holomorphic and delta TP is equal to 0, then from previous equations, yes, 920, we have these two equations. So, from another equation, we have also this equation. Comparing this equation and this equation, No, this equation. Then F is equal to 0 and delta I omega B is equal to theta KB I omega P. Hence the generalized Weizenberg formula and this equation, we have this equation. This means delta B minus KB I omega P square is non-positive. So by the generalized maximum principle, I omega P is constant. Again, from 29, and we obtain this equation. This means I omega P is parallel. Okay. Now, let MGM FJ be compact Riemann manifold with Kara foliation. Assume that KB is transversal holomorphic, then any transverse Killing R form is parallel for all R. R is greater than or equal to 2. For the proof, we define the operator R plus minus from this space to this space by this equation. Then by wrong calculations, we obtain this equation. So we have this equation, and also we have this equation. From this equation and the Weizenberg formula, Rxp is equal to 0. This means Fp is equal to 0. Since P is transversal Killing form, from the Weizenberg formula, the Laplacian of P is just this one. So by generalized Weizenberg formula and 39, we have this equation. So also by using the generalized maximum principle, P is parallel. So as a conclusion, on Riemannian foliation, if F is non-positive, then every transverse Killing or conformal R forms are parallel. If F is non-positive and additionally this equation under this conditions, then transverse conformal R forms are parallel. Yes, F is negative at some point, then there are no transverse conformal R forms. On Kara foliation, any transverse Killing R forms are parallel. We don't need any curvature conditions on Kara case. But in case of transverse conformal field, parallelism, I don't know until now. So, my talk is based on these two papers. So, I start my talk here.